This photo frame holds a certificate of ordination, which states that Venkat Rao has been ordained by the Church of the Latter-day Dude. Dudism is a jokey religion that originated from the movie The Big Lebowski. Garbanzo beans, also called chickpeas, 15 ounces or 425 grams.
The first thing we'll do is start recording audio that we'll associate with each object. Once the audio is recorded, we'll then transfer those files to a little memory card. It's this little chip right here that goes inside the touchboard. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, so since I use a Mac, I will use a QuickTime player to record my audio. If you use a Windows machine, you can use something like Sound Recorder that's built inside the Windows operating system. Again, a very simple tool, comes with Windows. So here what I'll do is, I have already started a audio recording, okay, so which I do by going to do into File and New Audio. And once I'm ready, I'm just gonna hit the record button right here and start my recording. Okay, I'll also make sure that I am using the right mic as well. Okay, so here we go. Garbanzo beans, also called chickpeas, 15 ounces or 425 grams. And there was our recording right there, and let's listen to it. Garbanzo beans, also called chickpeas, 15 ounces or 425 grams. All right, that's not bad at all. So we will use this one, and then similarly, we'll record audio for other objects as well. Okay, so let's see how we can provide audio descriptions to objects around us. So the first thing we need is what's called a touchboard. Okay, so this is manufactured by a company called Conductive, and essentially it's a little computer. Okay, and what it does very well is detect touch and convert them into digital signals. So, and you'll also see that it has all these holes up above, 12 holes, or they're called electrodes. So what we'll do is we'll use those holes to connect this touch board with an object. Okay, so we have an object like this one right here, a can of chickpeas. So we can connect these two through an alligator clip right here. Okay, so we can. So this wire has two clips at the end. So we can have one clip clipped to one of those electrodes on the touch board, and the other clip goes on to the chickpea can. And this arrangement right here is pretty simple, and it works very well because this is metallic. Okay, so as soon as I'll touch it, there will be some, you know, current that flows, which will be detected by the touch board. Now, what happens when our object is not metallic, right? So for example, we may have things like a photo frame right here. So this photo frame has a certificate in it, but it's made of wood. So how do we make sure that our, you know, touch on this photo frame is converted into a digital signal? So for that purpose, we have another thing. It's called an electric paint. Okay, so this comes with the bare conductive touch board. And this essentially, this paint, what it does is it allows current to flow from an object to another. So now, if you notice on this frame right here, what I've done is I have painted the surface with the electric paint. Okay, so you can probably see the difference right here. And now that we have this surface covered in electric paint, now I can, you know, have another alligator clip clipped to the surface right here, and the other end goes to the one of the electrodes on the touch board, on this touch board right here. Let's start putting everything together and make this work. Okay, so the first thing we'll do is we will take our memory card. Okay, so this is where all of our audio files are. In this example, there are just two. So we'll grab that memory card, and in the touch board, we will insert the memory card in this slot right here. Okay, so that's what I'm going to do. So, okay, it's the other way around, obviously, like always. So here it goes. Okay, I'll push it in so that it clicks. So now the memory card is right there. The next thing we'll do is we will also connect a little speaker for the audio output. Okay, so so that we could hear the sound. Okay, so that this audio speaker goes into this little hole right here. Okay, so that's connected. The next thing we'll do is we'll start connecting our objects. Okay, so I'm gonna grab one of these cables and connect it to my chickpea can. So here's E0 right there. Okay, and this goes to anywhere on the can. The other object that we have is the photo frame, right? So which is right here. So I have my one end of the cable connected already to the edge that has the electric paint. And the other end goes to the touch board, and it goes to electrode E1. All right, so there we go. And the last thing we'll do is we will power this touch board with a USB cable, and that goes into the USB port right there. Not sure if you can see it. Okay. There we go. Okay, so let's see it in action. Now, as soon as I touch each of these objects, their audio description is going to come out of this speaker right here. Let's start with a big certificate.
This photo frame holds a certificate of ordination, which states that Venkat Rao has been ordained by the Church of the Latter-day Dude. Dudism is a jokey religion that originated from the movie The Big Lebowski.
Well, it's not really jokey, it's kind of a serious religion, but it's fun. It did originate from the movie The Big Lebowski, but I digress. Let's go to the chickpeas.
Garbanzo beans, also called chickpeas, 15 ounces or 425 grams.
So as you can see, you can have any objects around the house that can be connected to this touch board right here and have
garbanzo beans, also called
audio descriptions of
15 ounces or 425 grams.
And you can have audio descriptions for each of these objects so that, you know, a person, so, you know, a blind person, for example, if they want to know what's around them, they can just touch those objects and get a good idea of what that object is. So, you know, it can be a certificate, it can be, you know, items in the kitchen, or you know, posters, or any artifact that you may have brought from a touristy place or what have you, right? So so this can be a good way to just let a blind person know what's around them.